Good morning. We are so glad that you have gathered with us for worship today. If you're still out in the lobby, we're going to invite you to come on in as we prepare our hearts for worship today. I want to remind you to grab a bulletin as you leave today so that you can see all of the things that are going on in the life of the body today. But I'm not going to spend time with announcements except to remind you that at the conclusion of our worship today, we'll move right into our annual business meeting. It'll be a very seamless transition. For those of you in the room who have children, I want to let you know that our children's workers will be bringing your kids back up the hall during our last song this morning so that you don't have to leave and get them and then come back. We're going to transition in such a way that it allows all of us to stay right here in this room and move into our meeting together. What I want to say to you this morning is this. Today, this morning, will be different than most weeks of worship here. We're going to be spending our morning in what we call a concert of prayer, praying in several ways and guided throughout our morning by leaders and servants inside our fellowship. We're going to use the ACTS model for prayer as our guide today. And ACTS is an acronym that stands for Adoration, Confession, Thanksgiving, and Supplication. And you will understand better what all of that means as we go through the service. The question, however, that needs to be answered is, why would we spend our entire morning to do something like this? Don't we pray every week? Why is this different? And I want to say this to you. God invites us throughout His Word to pray continually, to seek the Lord and His strength, to seek His face continually, to be anxious for nothing, but in everything with prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, to make our requests known to God. The call to pray isn't a suggestion, it's a divine invitation to engage in an intimate relationship with the Father. So why do we call this a concert? Because the definition in most of our minds of a concert is a public expression of music of some kind. Another definition of a concert says that concert means agreement, accordance, or harmony. And today we have both of those things in view. Because anytime God's people speak to Him, whether in joy or in sorrow, whether in hopeful anticipation or in lament, whether in deep places of need or in thanksgiving, all of that is music to God's ears. He just wants to hear the voice of His children. He longs to hear us as His people, just like a loving father enjoys hearing the voice of his children. It's our concert of voices today raised to the heavens. And so we come together in common agreement and one accord and unite as the body of Christ to bring our collective selves before the Lord in an act of harmony and in agreement. So today, you're going to receive some instruction and some guidance through the service, and we want to invite you to take whatever posture makes you comfortable so that you can engage with the Lord today. The altars are always going to be open all morning long. You don't need a specific invitation. If you want to come to this place to lay your burdens down before the Father, to praise Him, to tell Him how good He is, you can do that right where you are. You can do that here. You can stand. You can sit. Whatever way that you feel led to express yourself. But more than anything, hear the words of the prophet and let it guide your heart this morning. Seek the Lord while He may be found. Call on Him while He is near. The Holy Spirit is here, and God is listening. And so I invite you this morning to lift up your voices in praise, in thanksgiving, in confession, and in need to the Lord. And as our opening prayer this morning, hear now the words of the psalmist. And hear it as a prayer this morning and join me in asking the Father to guide our time. O my soul, I find rest in God. All of my hope, Lord, comes from You. Truly, You are my rock and salvation. You are my fortress. I will never be shaken. My salvation and my honor depend on You, God. You are my mighty rock. You are my refuge. Today we trust in You. At all times we trust in You. We will pour out our hearts to You, O Lord, for You are our refuge. Let's praise the Lord together this morning. And in an act of doing that, we want to invite our kids to come up this morning because we're going to start with you. So kiddos, come on up, and Miss Tabby and Miss Kelsey are going to have some special time with you this morning. All right, guys, I think we're going to start sitting, okay? So can you find a place to sit? Thank you. Okay. Catherine. Okay, I'm going to sit too over here. Okay, guys, so did you hear Miss Joy talk about how we're going to, today's all about prayer? Yeah. Have you guys been working on praying down the hall? Yeah. Okay. So this morning what we're going to start with is if you guys have any prayer requests. So the way this is going to go is we're going to talk about prayer requests. You guys are going to get to pray for those. And then we're going to kind of take a pause and people are going to come up and we're going to pray for you. Okay. So right now you get to pray for yourselves and each other and your prayer request. And then in a minute, we're going to pray for you. Okay. Does anybody have any prayer requests this morning that they, yes, Kat?
My mom and dad.
I love that. Anybody else? Okay.
Isla? My mama.
Okay. Sully? What you got?
My dad.
Okay. Gibby?
My grandma.
Jackson?
My uncle.
Okay. Nikki?
My grandpa.
Anybody else? Harper?
My mommy and my daddy.
Milo, you got one?
Who do you want to pray for?
Your veggie straws? Okay. Does anybody want to start our prayer? Okay. All right, Sully's going to start. We're going to pass it around, okay? So you can pray for your prayer request or you can pray for a friend's prayer request. Is everybody ready? Okay.
My friend.
God, thank you for Sullivan's friends. We're so thankful for our friends. Anybody else?
For my family.
Thank you, Lord, so much for our families. They are such a blessing to us. We're so thankful for our families.
Siblings?
Thank you, God, for our siblings. They are such a blessing in our lives. We're so thankful.
Mom and Dad.
Thank you for mommies and daddies who take care of us and love us. We're so thankful.
My mama.
Thank you for mamas and papas and grandmas and grandpas and the way that they love us. They are so special. Anybody else?
My mom and dad.
Thank you again for mom and dads. They are so special. Sorry, Jackson.
My mom.
Thank you for moms. We are so thankful for the people that take care of us, Lord. We thank you for all the ways that you care for us and that our children can take their needs to you. We are so thankful. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Okay, we are going to ask the youth, actually, if anybody's in here, to come forward first. If everybody will stand up and maybe step. Well, some of you can stay up there and some of you can stay down here. And our older students. High school, grade school, middle school, all the schools. Okay. All right. And now if anyone from the congregation would like to come and surround our children, we're going to do a covering of prayer for our kiddos. Okay. Okay. I don't know if they need to go down. I'll let everyone make their way up, and then we'll get started. fill her in. Kids, if some of you want to step down, you can. You don't have to stay up on the stage, okay? Yeah. Okay. God, thank you so much for these children. Thank you for the health and the happiness and the joy that they bring to this building. Lord, we feel exceedingly blessed for the number of kids that are on the stage and the number of kids that you're going to continue to bring into this place. We are so thankful.
Lord, we pray that as the leaders of these children, that you would help us to guide them in the way that you want. You have said that your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path, and I pray that we would teach our children that when they need your guidance, when they are sad, when they are happy, when they feel any emotion that they need guidance for, Lord, that that's where they would turn. We thank you that you have brought them into this room, that we get to celebrate them today, that we get to pray over them, Lord. We are so thankful. We pray that you would help us to guide them, that you would be the number one thing that they seek, that you would be the number one thing that we seek, so that we can set an example for them when they need something, that they would look to you, Lord. You are the only answer, and we pray that we would teach them that you are the only answer, Lord. We pray for the future children that were coming to this building, Lord. We pray for Wednesday night church. We pray that these students who maybe don't feel safe at home would walk into this building and feel your safety, Lord, that they would see that we are a place that loves the Lord and that we love them, Lord, and we pray that you would give them what they need through us and through your divine invitation into this building, Lord. We pray that you would grow this ministry in ways that we can't even imagine, Lord, that it would bring in children, it would bring in families, it would bring in students, that you would move in a way that we can't even see. And that you would use us and these students and these children to do your work, Lord. Lord, we pray as the caretakers of these children that you would be with us as well, that you would help us to use wisdom and that you would help us to commune together and use each other, Lord. When we're not sure what to do, we pray that we would seek you and find the answer that we need so that we can guide these children in the way that they need to be guided, Lord. We are so thankful for these children, Lord. We know what a blessing they are. And we pray that you would help us to guide them the way you want. And we just thank you so much for the opportunity to do so. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
And at this time, after all our grown-ups get seated, we're going to invite our youngest friends to go ahead and go toward the back. And our kids workers have a special time prepared for you this morning. And thank you, boys and girls, for reminding us that it's okay to share our needs out loud with the body of Christ.
As we move into our first area of focused prayer this morning, I want to talk to you about one of the most important aspects of prayer, just very briefly, and it's something that we don't necessarily talk about or do as often as we should, and that is adoration. King David reminds us to ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name, to worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. The psalmist tells us, praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Praise him for his acts of power. Praise him for his surpassing greatness. Praise him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and the lyre. Praise him with the timbrel and dancing. Praise him with the strings and pipe. Praise him with the clash of cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Adoration at its core is about showing deep love and respect to God. It's about worshiping God for who he is. We adore God. We give him adoration because he is due the adoration, because of his character. God is loving. God is gracious. God is merciful. God is compassionate. God is forgiving. God is full of goodness. God is faithful. You could attribute so many other things to God for who He is. Adoration is about adoring God because of His attributes, because of who He is. But adoration is not something that's simply confined to the past. Adoration, we adore God not only because of who He was or what He has done. We adore God because of who He is, what He's doing. And we give God adoration because of who He will be and what He will do. So as we continue seeking the Lord this morning, I'd like to invite you to gather with 3 or 4 or 5 people and share an attribute of God or a part of God's character that's meaningful to you. Then pray together, expressing your thanks and your adoration for who God is. So I'd invite you to do that at this time.
Will you pray with me? Heavenly Father, how wonderful you are. All creation is in awe of your power, and all glory belongs to you. We come to you in prayer this morning to glorify your name, not because of what you do for us, but because of who you are. When we slow down from our busy lives, all we have to do is look around to see your greatness displayed. How many times have we looked up at the night sky without any thought that not only did you envision it, but you created it? We pledge to you this morning that we will strive to look for you and give glory to you in everything that we see and touch, and that we will take time to admire how great you are by pausing to enjoy all that you have created. You are indeed a loving Father, and we have nothing to compare your love to. Scripture tells us that your love never ends, and great is your faithfulness. You gave us your only Son to save us. Such love is beyond our comprehension, Father. You deserve all the glory, honor, and praise we can offer, plus more. Dear God, this morning we say thank you. Thank you for being such a great and loving Father. We wholeheartedly choose this morning to praise you and your Son, Jesus, and acknowledge that you have all the power, that you deserve all the glory, and that you're always working for our good. All this we pray in your glorious name. Amen.
Excuse me. Now we're going to move into our time of confession, and I want to start by reading from 1 John. 1 John chapter 1, verse 8 through 9 says, "If we boast that we have no sin, we're only fooling ourselves and are strangers to the truth. But if we freely admit our sins, when his light uncovers them, he will be faithful to forgive us every single time. God is just to forgive us our sins because of Christ, and he will continue to cleanse us from all unrighteousness." When we hear the word confession, we often think of a gross, yucky time or a bad word. The world tells us that anything that we get, we have earned, but the kingdom does not work that way. We cannot fathom a scenario where we aren't rewarded based on our own individual efforts. Once we accept the fact that trying harder is not going to free us from our sins, and that only Jesus can do that, then we will begin to understand how we need his presence in our lives. We're sinners in need of his grace. God's plan for confession was to never make you feel condemnation, but the enemy would love for you to think that way. The enemy wants us to think that God is disappointed at you or mad at you, or that he's tired of picking you up and dusting you off time and time again. But that's not how God works. If you feel God bringing attention to a certain area of your life, it's because he wants to take that from you and give you something so much better in return. He only asks us to give up the things that are standing in the way of his perfect love for us. So today, if you're feeling the nudge from the Holy Spirit, quickly and freely give that thing in your life to God. We know that the Bible promises us in Isaiah that he will not only blot out our sins, but forget them completely. During this time, we'll switch from group prayers to individual prayers just between you and God. Of course, if you want someone to pray with you, please do that. From this point on, the altars will be open during the rest of the service. You can come up at any time. We also have communion tables prepared for the Lord's Supper, one up front and one in the back. You can take time to pray now and get communion during this time by yourself, with the group, with your family, or at any point during the rest of the service whenever you feel led to. Let's pray. Father, we come to you now asking that we can feel your presence with us at this very moment. We remember the reason for this communion and what it represents, and we thank you for the sacrifice that you made by sending your Son to die for our sins. We thank you for the relationship that we can now have because of that sacrifice. We now pray that you bless this bread that represents your body broken for us, and bless this cup which represents your blood poured out for us. We are continually in awe of your power, grace, and your love for us. And it's in your Son's name we pray. Amen.
Let us pray. Father, we want to give thanks to you for your majesty, for your love for us, for your Son, and for your Spirit that is with us, for your desire to bring your kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. Today we confess that we do not really know what that means, and we're not sure of the outworking of that in our lives, but we want to taste it. We want to be present in the coming of your kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. There are those days and hours when you're close, and we feel it, and it feels so real, and we rejoice and we glory in your presence. And then we confess there are those times when we want to pray, we feel the need to pray. We hardly know how to put our feelings and petitions into words. Sometimes the best we can do is utter, "O Lord," or "Ugh," or "Owned." And then we're quite capable of forgetting that you interpret the groans of our heart. We confess that we walk away and wondering where you are and assuming you don't hear us. And we think our communication is buffering, and that little circular wheel is there, and we'll check back later. Forgive our lack of faith and our lack of understanding, because we know you're always with us, even to the end of the earth. Your word says that perfect love casts out fear. And for those times when fear grips us and we turn to our old patterns and habits, sometimes we desperately seek to call or text someone or post something in a way that's beyond the prayerful way a fellow believer would support us. Forgive us. Remind us of your perfect love. We confess that we stop short of seeking perfect love and the healing that comes from your love. We confess there are times when memory and history floods in. Sometimes things we're not proud of and things that hurt us. And we're quick to become discouraged and guilty, self-centered. We strike out. We feel unredeemable. Forgive us for selling short your grace. For it is your grace and mercy that lifts us. In spite of our despair, you wash us clean and you set us on a solid rock. Let us not forget and slip into old ways of thinking, but be found securely in your grace and mercy. And this guy Jesus, who took upon himself all the sin of the world and defeated it, may we be found sitting at his feet, looking into his face, seeking to learn the vastness of the Father's love for us. And we confess that we sometimes look the other way. We take our eyes off the road, but we're reminded of Peter, who was so excited about walking on the water that he looked around as if to say, "Look at me, everybody." And then he began to sink. So in this hour, we seek to ever keep our eyes on you. Straight ahead, no distraction, eyes on Jesus. Jesus, we belong to you.
We're going to move into a time of thanksgiving. Really quickly, if you did bring an offering, we do have offering up in the front with the change for change jar and then also in the back. You're welcome to drop that off. I wanted to read a couple verses about Thanksgiving. Isaiah 12, 4 through 5 says, "And on that day you will say, 'Give thanks to the Lord, call on his name, make known his deeds among the peoples, make them remember that his name exalted. Praise the Lord in song for all he has done, glorious things. Let this be known throughout the whole earth.' James 1:17. Every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like a shifting shadow. Psalms 95, 1-6. Come on, everyone. Let's sing for joy to the Lord. Let's shout our loudest praises to our God who has saved us. Everyone, come meet his face with a thankful heart. Don't hold back your praises. Make him great by your shouts of joy. For the Lord is the greatest of all, King God over all other gods. In one hand he holds the mysteries of the earth, and in the other he holds the highest mountain peaks. He's the owner of every ocean, the engineer and sculptor of earth itself. Come and kneel before this creator God. Come and bow before the mighty God, our majestic maker. Thanksgiving is an incredible part of our prayer because it actually positions us for breakthrough. When we come into full recognition of agreement who God is, it changes us. When we take this a step further and we proclaim it, it changes things around us. So today we're going to proclaim our thanksgiving and worship as our prayer, so we can go ahead and stand and sing about how great our God is. Thank you.
to. I could sing these songs as I often do, but every song must end, and you never do. So wandering into the night, wanting a place to hide this weary soul, this bag of bones. I try with all my might, I just can't win the fight. I'm slowly drifting.
Thanksgiving. Before I start that, I wanted to read a verse, which, gosh, that just gets me fired up. Psalms 28:7, the Lord is my strength and my shield. I trust him with all my heart. He helps me, and my heart is filled with joy. I burst out in song of thanksgiving. And that's what we want to do today, is just burst out in song, whether it's singing or praying or worshiping or whatever that looks like, that we just burst it out in thankfulness to the Lord. Heavenly Father, the word thankful just seems so inadequate. We are overwhelmed by all that you do for us. That is the word that I think of today. You are constant. You're faithful to us every second of every day. If ever we're not feeling your presence, it's not you that's leaving. It's us that's turning in the wrong direction, Lord. You've never not been there, and we so don't deserve that. But what you have done for us, what you are doing for us, what you're doing today, through all of this time of prayer with our church family, Lord, we are so thankful. Thankful for what you did, for how you sent your son for us, knowing that we needed that we would need that, for what he endured for each one of us. We were on his mind that day. We are on his mind every day. And we're thankful that with these moments of prayer, there's no right or wrong, Lord. You just want to hear our voice. No matter what it sounds like, as we're speaking to you, that is all you want. We're thankful for your guidance. We're thankful for our church family that helps each other, supports each other, lifts each other up, supports each other with our families, as we all want to be just guided closer to you, ways that we lead our families, ways that we show your love out in the community. We're just thankful for all the support you give us, not only through yourself and through your son, but through those you surround us with, Lord. And that is what we are each and every day, Lord. It's gratitude. It's overwhelming. And, Lord, we are thankful. It's in all these things we pray, Lord. Amen.
All right. Can you be seated. Tabby, sit down, please. Just kidding. Can you guys just take a second to thank the worship team, please? So what we're going to do right now is move into a time of supplication. And supplication is a big word. Sorry, Steve, I'm not talking into the mic. I am now. So supplication means that we are presenting our request to God. So Joy read this earlier, Philippians 4, 6 and 7. Yep, I'm going to read it out of a different translation. So just listen. Don't be pulled in different directions or worried about a thing. Be saturated in prayer throughout each day, offering your faith-filled requests before God with overflowing gratitude. Tell him every detail of your life. Then God's wonderful peace that transcends human understanding will guard your heart and mind through Jesus Christ. What a promise that we have. Are you aware that you are a co-laborer with God? That means that there is conversation between you and the God that created the universe about what the next plans are. You have biblical responsibility and permission to come to God with every request in your heart and have a dialogue about it. Right? That is what we're going to be doing during this time of supplication. So I have a few instructions for you before we do that. So you, as always, like Joy said earlier, the altars are still welcome. The Lord's Supper is still here for you to take. Maybe you want to take it again, that's totally fine. So you are welcome to pray individually. You are welcome to pray with your family. You are welcome to pray in groups like we did earlier. Whatever way that you want to talk to God in this moment, that is totally up to you. We do have a few people positioned for specific things. If you want to go after something in prayer this morning, we have a few different people that are positioned. So Brittany, Britt and Eric Campagna are going to be right up here in the front. They're going to be praying over families. If your family needs something, or if you know a different family that needs something, or if you just want to pray over the families in the church or in our community or anything, we want you to go here. And there certainly, if you need prayer over something specific, you don't need to go into all the detail. You don't need to tell the 10-minute story. We don't have time for that, though I love you. But just give some short explanation, and they are prepared to pray and help contend for breakthrough on your behalf and the behalf of families. Larry Whitaker is going to be in the back. Larry, wave your hand. He's so excited to be doing this. Thank you, Larry. Larry is going, and Linda also, they're going to be back there ready to pray for the nation. If God has planted it deep in your heart that you... the nation is on your heart, that the things that we're going through, that the time we're coming into, that's on your heart. They are going to be back there, and they are prepared to share concerns. I say that loosely. It's a time for prayer. It's a time to contend with the Lord. Eli Sherman is going to be in the back of the overflow. Students, if there's any students in here, this is a time for just you guys to go back and be honest and real with each other about whatever it is and pray about whatever. And then Pastor John is going to be at the front of the overflow, and he's going to be praying over homeschooling families, administration, teacher, students, all of it. If that's on your heart to pray for, he's going to be right up here at the front of the overflow to do that. And then also, you don't have to stay in one place the entire time. We've got a little bit of extra time for this section so that you can move around as you see fit. Pastor Joy's going to be up at the front, and she's got some oil for anointing. Now, the oil doesn't mean anything. It's an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace. So if you need healing in your body, if you need breakthrough for your family, if you just want more of the Holy Spirit, come up here, and Joy is going to be ready to pray for you and anoint you. And if you aren't on our intercessory team, can you just wave your hand real quick? Or if you're an elder, wave it higher, Trey. Thank you. So these people are also ready to pray for you if you need prayer. We really just want to go after whatever it is that the Lord has on your heart to go after. Whatever you need, God is prepared to discuss with you about it. He wants to hear your heart on it. And more importantly, he wants to show you his heart for it, because I bet it's better than you ever imagined. Okay. Did I say everything? Okay. Go. Thank you. All right. That was good. That was really good. I'm going to just pray a prayer for our for the time of supplication that we just had, and then we're going to close the service out with a really, really good song. If you are able, just lift your hands to the Lord while I pray. Father, I thank you for everything that you are and the things that you are for us that we have no idea. I thank you for the privilege that we have to come to you with every need in our heart. I thank you for the Holy Spirit who super intercedes on our behalf, Father, that there is nothing that we desire that you don't know about. There is no need that we have that you do not have a solution for, God. I thank you just for the Holy Spirit rumble around this room while we were praying, God, and that you are pleased with that sound, and you are pleased with your children when they come to you, Father. And so we just thank you. We thank you that you hear every need and that you supply everything we could ever need, Father. You are so good to us. You are so, so good. And we thank you, and we in faith receive every blessing that you have for us, individually, as families, and as a body, and for our town. In faith, we receive those blessings, God, and we know that they are coming because you are good, not because of anything that we have done, not because we could earn it, but just because you are good, Father. We ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. If you still need prayer, there's still prayer happening. That can happen during worship, or if you need to stay later after service and you want prayer, that's fine too. But right now, go ahead and stand, and we're going to close out our service in worship.
Who else would rocks cry out to worship? Whose glory taught the stars to shine? Perhaps creation longs to have the words to sing, but this joy is mine. With a thousand hallelujahs, we magnify your name. You alone deserve the glory, the honor, and the praise. Lord Jesus, this song is forever. This song is forever.